The first piece of the puzzle is our absolute reliance on water. It's a resource that can't be replaced, which is why it's so imperative we protect it. Let's take a quick look at different ways we use water. We all need drinking water. A human can go weeks without food, but only days without water. And we don't just need water to survive, we need clean water. Drinking water accounts for a tiny percentage of our overall water usage, less than 1%, but it's one of the most important of all the uses. We also need water that works for us, doing the dirty household jobs like laundry and cleaning, for growing gardens and keeping lawns green. Beyond household chores are the heavy-duty jobs in industry. Water is used in many manufacturing processes, as an ingredient in food production, as a coolant for producing steel and power, as the driving force in hydroelectric generation. The list goes on and on. One of water's biggest jobs is helping to feed the world. Water is essential to agriculture. Without it, farmers couldn't grow crops or produce livestock. Beyond its use in the production of goods, water is often used to transport those goods to market. Waterways are integral to national and worldwide shipping. When water's not working, it's playing. One of its most popular uses is for recreation. Whether it's swimming, water skiing, fishing, the water's got to be clean. Polluted recreational waters spell trouble for both humans and wildlife. Which brings us to the final use, habitat for wildlife. Rivers, lakes, and oceans support entire diverse and fragile ecosystems. Ecosystems that can be shattered by even the smallest changes in water's quality. We depend so heavily on water. Isn't it ironic that many of the ways we use it are actually impairing its quality? Careless industrial use of water can contaminate the resource with toxic chemicals. Recreational boats and jet skis can dump gas and oil into the very water we want to enjoy. If the ways we use water were the only practices creating pollution problems, the puzzle would be solved. We'd just change the ways we use water. But it's not that simple. A whole range of practices, the individual actions we take and decisions we make, affect water quality.
We all live downstream of someone else, and there's someone else that lives downstream of us that needs to utilize that water. So it's important to be careful at how you use the watershed and the land in that area and what you might be introducing into that water body.
One person's decision to properly dispose of paint keeps that paint out of a stream. One developer's decision to control erosion keeps sediment out of a river. Multiply those individual decisions across an entire community, and you can see the impact proper practices can have.